You one second. Now I am sharing assignment 2. Please complete in some in 1 week or 2 week in this week. I think in the July 1st week or 2nd week, maybe after reopening, you have to submit both assignment 1 and assignment 2. Now, it may be in July 2nd week, I think there will be a reopening. So by that time, you have to submit. What I'm telling is now you will be in leisure, so complete it. Afterwards, after reopening, there will be line mid exams and final exams, lab exams like that only. So it will be difficult. So first, try to complete assignment 1, assignment 2, and lab also. The lab manual I have already shared. Again, I will share now. So assignment 1 and lab manual I will share. At the same way, I will share you previous question papers. Okay. So once see them. Okay. So three things I have shared with you. So one is assignment, second one is the previous question papers, and third one is DS lab manual. So by seeing DS lab manual, try to complete the the lab record, and assignment 1, assignment 2, try to complete by this weekend. So that it will be easy for you. Just after reopening, directly there will be mid exams, something like that one. So it will be very difficult for you. Okay. So, okay. So today we will be seeing the in the previous classes we have seen many things about graphs, that is DFS, BFS, and what are the other things we have seen? Prim's algorithm, Kruskal's algorithm, DFS, BFS, all these things we have discussed. Now we will be discussing now the last topic known as shortest path algorithm. So what do you mean by all pair shortest path? So in the name itself, it is there, all pair shortest path. That means if you take any pair of two vertices, there may be many paths connecting the two vertices, but I should know the least one. I should know the least connecting graph. So before going to know what do you mean by all pair shortest path algorithm, first we will be knowing what do you mean by transitive closure. You should know the definition of transitive closure. Then only you can understand the subject of all pair shortest path algorithm. So I can see here. So for example, I think is it visible? Can anybody chat with me? Is it visible and audible? So you can see here. So given a directed graph, find out a vertex J is reachable from another vertex I for all vertex pairs ij in a given graph. Here reachable means that there is a path from vertex I to j. The reachability matrix is called by the transitive closure of a graph. So you can see. So first you should know the definition of transitive closure. Okay. You can see. So this is the diagram. So first see, if I can reach from vertex I to vertex j in any path, if there is any path through which I can reach from vertex I to j, then I should keep one in the transitive closure vertex, otherwise zero. So if a path exists between I and J, vertex I and J, then the corresponding value in the matrix is 1. Okay, you can see here. So for example, take this from 0 I can reach 1, from 0 I can reach 2, from 0 I can reach 3 also in indirect form, that is 0 to 2, 2 to 3. So you can see all ones. So 0 to 0 I can reach, 0 to 1 I can reach, 0 to 2, 0 to 3. Next, from 1 to 1 I can reach, from 1 to 0 is I can reach. See, from 1 to 0 how will we reach? 1 to 2 and 2 to 0 I can reach. Again, from 1 to 2 also I can reach, from 1 to 3 also I can reach. So all the vertices I can reach from 1. So in the same way, see, first one is 1, 1, 2, I will write this one. I think previously it was not visible. Okay, see, the in the given example graph, from 0 to 0 I can reach. So first one is 1. So you can see from 0 to 0 I can reach, so it is 1. From 0 to 1 I can reach. So you can see. So from 0 to 0 I can reach. From 0 to 1 also I can reach. From 0 to 1 also I can reach. From 0 to 2 also I can reach. From 0 to 3 also I can reach. Because from 0 to 2, 2 to 3, there is a path. So from in that row of 0, all are 1s. Next, 1, from 1. From 1 to 1 I can reach. From 1 to 0 also I can reach. How? From 1 to 2 and 2 to 0. From 1 to 3 also I can reach, from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. So from 2 to 2 I can reach, because the same means I can reach. So 1. From 2 to 0 I can reach, so it is 1. From 2 to 3 also I can reach, that's why it is 1. Again, from 3 to T it is 0. From 3 to 2 I can't reach. See, 3 to 3 is 1. So within the same self means I can reach. So one, from 3 to 2 I can't reach. Do no array is there. That's why 0. 3 to 1 also I can't reach. 3 to 0 also I can't reach. So there is no path from 3 to 2, 3 to 0, 3 to 1. So all zeros. So this is the trans to closure. So if there is a path between any two vertices, maybe number of intermediate vertices may be different. Then it is a trans to closure. Then it is a then the trans to closure matrix will be the value of that cell will be 1 if there is a path between I and j. There is no path, it is 0 in the trans to closure vertices. How will we build the trans to closure vertex graph? By using the adjacency matrix. By using the adjacency matrix, I will build this trans to closure. So now we will discuss the Floridsen-Warshall's algorithm, which is based on that trans to closure. So you can see. So what is Floridsen-Warshall's algorithm? It is an algorithm for finding the shortest path between all pairs of vertices in a weighted graph. So in a weighted graph, there will be different paths for connecting different vertices. If you take any pair, say vertex 2 and vertex 3, there may be 2 or 3 paths, but I want the shortest path between vertex 2 and vertex 3. So Floridsen-Warshall algorithm gives the all pairs shortest path algorithm in 1 minute. In one word, all pairs, until say all pair vertices. That means all pair vertices shortest path algorithm. Okay. So 1 minute. This algorithm works with both directed and undirected graphs. So a weighted graph is in which each edge has a numerical value. So Floyd's algorithm, we call it all just Floyd's Warshall's, but we call it as Floyd's or Warshall's, everything is okay. Now how it works, first we will say, for example, this is a graph. So first what I will build, see, following the stages or shortest path, all this, create a matrix A naught of dimension n by n, where n is the number of vertices. The row and column are indexed as I and j respectively. I and j are the vertices of the graph. Each cell A of ij is filled with the distance from ith vertex to jth vertex. If there is no path from ith vertex to jth vertex, 1 minute, then the cell is left as infinite. Fill each cell with the distance of ith and jth vertex. So you can see. So now see how I will build the A naught vertex, A naught matrix. See from what in this graph, you can see it. One minute. Small error. I will rectify that one. One minute. First, I will build the matrix A power 0. So how we will see? See, from 1 to 1, it's there. From 1 to 1, there is a, what is the distance? 0. From 1 to 2, from 1 to 2, I can reach with distance 3. From 1 to 3, see, from 1 to 3, see, 1 to 3, I can reach, but I can't reach with one step. With zero steps, I can't reach. That's why it is known as infinite. So we see, A power 0 means what? I should first write the adjacency matrix. Just adjacent, if there is any matrix, I have to write that. Okay? Next, 1 to 4. 1 to 4, how much? 5. Value is 5. Next. 2 to 1, in one step only I am going. So the weight is 2. See, if this is the A0 is adjacency matrix with weights. Adjacency matrix is what? If adjacency matrix gives whether a given vertex is in the neighbor or not. But what I am telling A0 is in weighted adjacency matrix. Weighted means what? It will give the weight of the adjacency matrix. Weight. It will give the weight. If there is adjacency matrix, it is okay. If there is no adjacent vertex, it will be filled with infinite. If it is adjacent, what is the weight? At what weight I can reach that adjacent vertex, it will be written here. So you can see. From 2 to 1, in what weight I will go? In value 2. From 2 to 2, that is same. In 0th distance, I will reach 2 to 2. Next, 2 to 3. So see, from 2 to 3, there is no arrow. This is a directed graph. Directed graph means each edge will have some direction. This is not an undirected graph. If it is an undirected graph, I can reach 2 to 3 in one adjacency step. But here, 2 to 3, there is no, it is not an undirected graph. And there is no edge from 2 to 3. 3 to 2 is there. 2 to 3 is not there. So from 2, I will first go to 4. And 4 to 3. I should reach. So in two steps, I will be reaching. In adjacency, I can't reach. So 3 is not adjacent to 2. So that's why infinite value is returned. Second, 2 to 5. 2 to 4. In 2 to 4, in 4, in the weight is 4. In one edge only, I can reach. 4 is adjacent to 2. And what's the weight? 4. So I have written 4 here. Okay. You can see. So that's the thing. And again, from three to one, I can reach. There is a path, but one is not adjacent to three. So I have written infinite. Next, from 3 to 2, I can reach in one step. 2 is adjacent to 3. That's why I have written the value of that edge 1. So again, 3 to 3, 0. 3 to 4, from 3 to 4, I can reach. From 3 to 4, I can reach. But there is no, it is not adjacent. 4 is not adjacent to 3. Indirectly, I can reach 4. That is 3 to 2 and 2 to 4, I can reach. So I have written infinite. So why I have written infinite? I can't reach in one step. I can't reach this vertex to from third vertex. I can't reach in fourth vertex in one step. That's why it was an infinite. Next. From 4 to 1. From 4 to 1. I can't reach. Directly 1 is not adjacent to 4. I can reach from 4 to 1 indirectly. But I can't reach 1 directly. So it is written as infinite. From 4 to 2, here also indirectly I can reach, but 2 is not adjacent to 4, so it is known as infinite. 4 to 3, 4 to 3, in 2 steps I can, 3 is adjacent to 4, and the value of that edge is 2, so I have written 3. 4 to 4, again I can reach from 4 to 4 in 0th distance. So that's right. So I think you have understood A0. So I will be building. First, I will build weighted adjacency matrix. From weighted adjacency matrix, I will be building the all pair shortest path algorithm. So you can see now. See what it tells. It tells the adjacency weighted list. Next. Now create a matrix AI using matrix A0. The elements in the first 1 minute. What it tells? Now, what is the next step? First, you have to understand how I will build in the first step adjacency weighted matrix. Now, create a matrix A1 using A0. The elements in the first column and the first row are left as they are. The remaining cells are filled in the following. So, next step. So I will be building the matrix A1 by using A0. Again, I will be building A2 by using A1, A3 by using A2, some like that one. That the hierarchy will be like that. But the what is A0 matrix? It is the adjacent weighted matrix, weighted adjacency matrix. So first I will start at weighted adjacency matrix, and then I will, the final step, first step is build a weighted adjacency matrix. Last step is build an all pairs shortest path matrix. So now, create a matrix A1 using A0. The elements in the first column and first row are left as they are. So first column and first row are left like that only. The remaining cells will be as follows. Let K be the intermediate vertex in the shortest path from source to destination. In this step, K is the first vertex. So Aij is filled with Aik plus Akj. If Aij is greater than Aik plus Akj. So now you have to understand that one. That is, if a direct distance from the source to the destination is greater than the path through the vertex K, then the cell is filled with Aik plus Akj. So in the same way, so now see how I will build A1. So how I will build A1. So what you have to understand is first row, first column and the diagonal are same. See here, A1 while writing. From A0, I have derived A1. in from a naught, when I derive a1, first row and first column are same and the diagonal are same, all the next elements will be changing. What he is telling is how a1 means what? Number of intermediate nodes I have to touch, and for reaching the destination. See, from source I have started, in intermediate, while reaching the destination, in between source and destination, only one vertex should be there. So that's why it is written as A1. So previously A0 means what? Adjacency. That means from vertex I to vertex J, in between vertex I and vertex J, there is no intermediate vertex. It is, so that's why A0 is known as adjacency weighted matrix. Adjacency means what? Some vertex is known as adjacent means what? There is no intermediate vertex to reach that vertex. In one step only I can reach. That is, source and destination are connected by directly one edge. So that's why the value is represented as a power 0. That means there are zero intermediate nodes. Now what I'm building A1. A1 means what? There are, from source to destination, they at most I can accept one intermediate node. That's the meaning here. If A2 means what? A power 2 means what? From source to destination, to reach destination from source, I can have at most two vertices. A power 3 means what? From starting from source to for reaching the destination, I can have at most three vertices. Like that. So now, what is K? So K is an intermediate vertex. For example, I want to reach from vertex 2 to vertex 3. So in between, I can have intermediate node as 1, intermediate node as 2, intermediate node as 3, intermediate node as 4. Only one vertex is allowed. So that vertex is represented by K. You can see the diagram here. So what is the blind rule? Whenever I am building from A1 from A0, A2 from A1, A3 from A2, keep the first row and first column same and the diagonal as the same. All other elements will be changing. So you can see here, from A1, see, our first row and first column are same and the diagonal are same as A0. All the remaining elements will be changing. So we will see, from 2 to 3, if you take in the previous example, from 2 to 3, infinite, in one step I can't go. Infinite means what? Previously infinite value is there. In one step I can't. In zero steps I can't go. But see the diagram here. In two steps I can get. See, in one intermediate node, that is if I start at 2 and reach 3, in between there is a vertex 4, then I can reach. So from 2 to 3, if I take intermediate node vertex as 4, I can reach. So that value is how much? 6. From 2 to 4 is 4, and 4 to 3 is 2. Total 6. The value is 6. 6 and previous value is A0 value is 2 to 3. How much value? It is infinite. That is, which is greater? Infinite is greater or 6 is greater? Infinite is greater. So we will write, we want the shortest path. So 6 is less than infinite. So I will write 6 there. 6, 9 is written. Okay, 1 minute. 2 to 3 now. 1 minute. Okay, he has made small. See, he is taken as k is equal to 1. K is vertex 1. So in this step, k is vertex 1. So the intermediate node for see, a 1 means what he has taken the intermediate vertex as 1. So what you so if I take the intermediate vertex as 1, so you can see. So if I have to reach to from 2 to 3, in between the vertex is 1. So what will be the distance? 2 to 1, 5 to 1 to 4, and 4 to 3. So if I want to reach 2 to 3 based on the vertex 1, so what will be the value? 1 minute. So 9 will be the value. So it was written like that. 9 is written like that. So 9 is written like that. Again, 2 to 4. See, 2 to 4. And the intermediate vertex is 1. So I will reach from 2 to 1 and 1 to 4. So what will be the value? 2 to 1, 2 plus 1 to 4, 5, 7. So that the value is 7. But it is 4 which is written. Okay, 1 minute, what we will see. Why it is written 2 to 4. For example, 2 to 4, the distance from vertex 2 to 4 is 4. And the sum of distance from between 2 to 4. Okay. See what he is trying, what he is doing is actually. See. From 2 to 4, actually, in if I take the intermediate node as 0, that is in one step, the value of distance is 4. But if I reach from 2 to 4 and the intermediate node is 1, through 1, if I reach like that, then what's the value? 2 plus 5, 7. 7 and 4, which is less? 4 is less. So I will reach from 2 to 4 by using 4. So that's why I will take which is the less one. So I will compare the previous A0 matrix and I will compute the present value and I will compare, I will take the which is less value. So you can see. So in A0, 2 to 4 value is 4. So, but here if I go through in A1, the value is 7, that I have to go through 1. I should not go directly, I should pass through vertex 1. Then the value is 2 plus 5, 7. So that's why it is 4. Again, from 3 to 2, if you take 3 to 2. See, 3 to 2. See, in 3 to 2, in A0 matrix, it is 1. I have to see if there is anything less than that one. 3 to 2. See, from 3 to 2, there is only one value from, I can't reach 3 to 2 by using 1. Directly, I should, from 3 to 2 only is there. There is no indirect path through in which I can pass through node 1. So, directly 3 to 2 is the only option and the value is 1. That's why I write that one, that value is wrong. So next, 3 to 4. So 3 to 4. So 3 to 4, there are many paths. Previous path is 5. 1 minute, three, no, no. Previous path is infinite, I think. Yes. 3 to 4, previous path is infinite. That is in one step I can't reach. So now in 3 to 4, indirectly with what value I can reach? 3 to 2, 1, 2 to 4, 4. So in value 5, with value 5 I can reach. In distance, by using distance 5 I can reach. But he has written 8, 1 minute we'll see. Why he has written 8? Some 3 to 2 is okay. 3 to 4, he has written 8, we will see. 3 to 8, previous value is infinite. 3 to 4, previous value is infinite. The value is 5. Oh, no, no, no. I have to reach 3 to 4 by using the vertex 1. I should pass through 1. So that's why you have to write, see, from 3 to 2, 1, from 2 to 1, 2, from 1 to 4, 5. So the value is 8. So I have written 8 here. So A1 means what? The intermediate vertex is 1. A0 means what? The intermediate vertex is A0. That means no vertex. So A power 2 means what? The intermediate vertex through which I have to pass through for reaching the destination from a given source vertex I to reach the destination vertex J, I have to compulsorily pass through vertex 1. A power 2 means I have to compulsorily pass through vertex 2. So if I pass through vertex 2 and previous some value is there in A0 and A1, I have to compare that one. Which is less one, I will be writing there. Okay. So here it's work. Now see, 4 to 1 is, now I have to write a C. 4 to 2, I have to compute 4 to 2. So I have the star, source vertex is 4, destination vertex is 2. So the value is infinite here. So the value is infinite. From previously in A0, it is infinite. Now we will compute by using A1. See, I have to go, I have to reach from 4 to 2. In between the intermediate node is 1. See, is there any possibility like that one? 4, 3, and compulsorily I have to go to 2. There is no other option. So 3 is the value. 4 to 3, 3 to 2. There is no other option through which I can go to the destination vertex 2 through vertex 1. The intermediate vertex should be 1, but there is no possibility. From 4 to 3 there is only one possibility, and 3 to 2 is only one possibility. There is no other path in which I can include 1. So the value is 3. 2 plus 1, 3. The value is 2 plus 3. 1 minute. 4 to 2. Okay. He has written infinite. Why he has written infinite? Tell me. Why he has written infinite means, because there is no path between 4 to 2 which includes 1. Which includes 1. That's why he has written infinite there. 4 to 3. See, 4 to 3. Take 4 to 3. In A0, the value is 2. Now I should take another path through which I will be going, I should include the intermediate vertex 1. So 4 to 3. See, 4 to 3, only one edge is there, that is 2. There is no other possibility. So if the source vertex is 4 and the destination is 3, to reach 3 from 4, there is only one way, that is 4 to 3. With distance 2. I can't include vertex 1. So this is the shortest path. Already 2 is there, that is the value. No new way is there which includes value vertex 1. So what I should do? I should keep the value 2. So in A1, I should compare the value at 2 and infinite. The value is 2 is small. So I will write 2. You can see. So what you have to understand is, from A0 I will write A1. From A1 I will write A2. From A2 I will write A3. But at the same time, see, if I'm writing A1, I will take the path which includes vertex 1. If it is greater than the path of A0 between I and J, I will take the value of A0. If A1 is less than A1 for the same cell, for the same pair of vertices from 2 to 3 or 3 to 2, then I will take the value of A1. Okay, that's it. So in the same way. Now epoch 2. So in epoch 2 also you have what you have to take? You should keep the value of the diagonal 0, 0, 0 same, and second column and second row same, and all the other values will change. For example, I will first consider 1 and 3 from vertex 1 to 3, which includes the intermediate node as 2. I will compare with A1. So they take the pair 1, 3. What is the value in A1, 1, 3? In 1, 3, the value is infinite. That is, I can't go from 1 to 3, which includes A1, which includes 1. So, infinite. Now, I should, by seeing the diagram, I should tell which whether it includes, whether one, from 1 I can reach 3 by using the intermediate node 2. So, you can see. From 1 to 2 is 3, 2 to 3 is 1. So, what's the total value? 4. So, 4 and infinite. Which is small? 4 is small. So what I will write? 4 I will write. Oh, what he has written? From 1, 2, 3, 9 he has written. See. 1, 2, 3, 9. Why he has written? See. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. He has written 9. See. From 1, 2, 3. So in A power 2, I should write the value which includes the intermediate node 2. So I will start at 1, I will reach 2, from 2 to 4, and 4 to 3. So what's the value, total value? From 1 to 2, the value is 3. From 2 to 4, the value is 4. From 4 to 3, the value is 2. So what's the total value? 9. So 9 and infinite. So in A1, what's the same value? In A1, it is infinite, you can see. In 1-3 pair, if you take, it is as infinite. Now, the present value, that is in A power 2, which includes from the source vertex is 1 and destination vertex is 3. I should start at 1 and I should reach 3. In between the intermediate node is 2. So, what's the value? 9 is the value. 9 and infinite, which is the small one? 9 is the small one. So I have written 9 here. So you can see 9. In 1-3 pair, if you take, the value is 9. In that way, I will be computing all the other values. In the same way, I will be computing A3, A4. So A4 is the last one. So A4, what A4 tells? It tells the all pair shortest path algorithm. That means if you take any pair of vertices, I will be getting the path with least distance. I will be getting the path with least distance. That is, if you take in A4, if you take combination of vertex 2, 4. So the value is 4. That means I can start from 2, I can reach 4 in many ways, in many paths, but the least value is 4. So that's the thing. So in this way, I will be building the matrix. This is the matrix I will be building. This matrix gives the all pair shortest path algorithm. So once you have to practice, first A0, how to write the A0, next A1, A2, A3, A4. So why A4 I stopped? We have only 4 vertices. So number of rows are 4, number of the columns are 4. So I stopped there. So A4 is fine. So you can see. So, and the same thing I have written in C program. I have written in an algorithm. I have written C. N is equal number of vertices. A is equal matrix. For K is equal 1 to N. For I is equal to 1 to N. For J is equal to 1 to N. A of A power K, I J is equal to minimum of A power K J, K minus 1, I J, comma, minimum of A power K minus 1, I comma K plus A power K minus 1, K comma J. Okay. Once if you see the algorithm and if you have to take a diagram and step by step by using this algorithm, you have to first build A0, next A1, A2. Then only you can understand. Until this, I will be telling like this only, you will be hearing like that only. You can't understand. So For the same algorithm, I have written a C program here. You can see here. For C program, the same thing you can see here. For the same thing, I have written a C program. Okay, this C programs gives the final vertex or final matrices. So you have to execute that one. So the same thing it is written. See, for k is equal to 0, k less than nv, k plus plus new value, that is a number of vertices. Nv, we can take n, but he is taking nv, that is number of vertices. From j is equal to j less than nv, j plus plus. If matrix ik plus matrix kj is less than matrix ij, matrix ik plus matrix kj, whichever is less than less value, which cell is less than the previous matrix, I will compare the present cell value of the cell of the present vertex, present matrices, and I will compare with the previous matrices. Whichever is small, I will write that one. So here k is the intermediate node. So you can see here, from k is equal to 0, k less than nv, k plus plus, I will start at 0 and I will end at last vertex. So first I will take 0th vertex as intermediate node, next 2, next 1, next 3, like that one. So I will be printing the, so this is the program. Anyway, I will be sharing all these things. And another algorithm is the Dijkstra's algorithm. It is also all pair shortest path algorithm. I will be explaining in the next class. So that, for that, with that one, I will be completing the topic of graphs. Okay, we will see in the next class if there any another thing like that. Okay, so today I will be ending the session. I will be sharing all this material to you. Okay, all things I have shared up to now. Assignment 1, assignment 2 I shared, lab manual I have shared, previous question papers I have shared. All of you, please complete the assignments quickly so that it will be easier when the college reopens to attend the mid exams and write the final exams also. Okay, so I will be ending the session. If you have any doubt, you can call me and my number is available in our group. Okay, thank you.